Hello guys, welcome back once again. This is Jagrat here, and in the today's session we are going to cover our last topic, that is how to encrypt as well as decrypt password in Selenium. Okay, so guys, this is very small topic but very important. Okay, so why it is important, let me show you. So let us suppose, guys, this is a site that is demo.automationtesting.in, and we want to enter here password, but I don't want to disclose my actual password to the users. Okay, because guys, when you will write the script, you will definitely use the send keys method, and inside send keys method you need to enter your password. Okay, but I don't want to enter my actual password. Okay, so here I will enter encrypted password. Okay guys, I will convert my actual password into the encrypted password, and that actual encrypted password will be entered here. Okay, so let me show you that how can we convert it. So guys, this is a very simple code. Okay, 2 to 3 lines of code and that's it. So encrypted and decrypted pwd. Let us suppose this is my class name. Just click on public static void main and then just click on finish. Okay, so let us suppose my actual password is, let us suppose abc@1234. Okay, so let us suppose this is my actual password. Now I am going to convert this actual password into encrypted password. So guys, there is a class, that is base64 class will be there. So we will use this class, and there is a method, that is encode base64 method. Okay, so this method we will use. So this method will take the byte argument. Okay, but guys, we have the string variable, so we need to convert this string into byte. So how can we convert this? So this is my reference variable, and dot get bytes method will be used. Okay guys, so now it will be converted into the bytes, and this method will store in byte format. So let us suppose this is my encrypted pwd. Okay, so this is my encrypted password. Now I want to store it in again a string, so that it will be we can print it in the console. So let me write here guys. So let us suppose I am writing here original password before encryption is, okay, and what is my original password? That is pwd. Okay, so this is my original password. Now system.out.println, here I will write password after encryption is. Okay, so now again we need to convert this into a string. Okay, so new string, and I will pass this encrypted pwd like this. Okay guys, so that's it. This is the concept to convert your actual password into the encrypted passwords. Okay, so this is the password encryption, that's it. Okay, so let me run this program and let's see whether it is working fine or not. So we ran this program, so let me check. So guys, you can see here original password is this and password after encryption is this. So guys, you can see here my original password has been encrypted. Okay, now I will decrypt this encrypted password. Okay, so the output would be the original password. So this is now is password decryption. Okay, so how can we do this? Again guys, there is a class base64 and here I will use decode base64 class. Okay, and this will accept the byte, so we have already encrypted password in byte, so we can directly pass here like this, and we will store it in byte. Let us suppose this is encrypted, so this is decrypted password. Okay, decrypted password, and like this. Okay guys, so again this decrypted password in the form of byte, so we need to convert it into the string. So let me copy this and let me paste here. So password after decryption is okay, and here I will pass this decrypted password. That's it. Okay, so original password is abc@1234. After encrypted, this is, so when we will decrypt this password, again the output would be the original password. Okay, so let's run this program and let's see whether it is working fine or not. So guys, you can see here, this is my original. Okay, then we encrypted this password, and when again when we decrypt this password, so we will get the our original password. See, okay, so let's run this again. See, okay guys, so this is the way through which we can encrypt as well as decrypt our password. Okay, so this was the very small session but very useful. Please use this concept while entering the password in your script. Okay, don't enter your actual password in any case. Okay, that's why I took the session for encryption and decryption of the password. Okay guys, so that's all about this session. So this session is completed, so let me mark it as completed. So guys, if you really like this video, then please like, share and subscribe. Okay, so Selenium standalone classes are completed. Now we will move towards the framework part. Okay guys, so we will move towards the framework part. We will develop the live framework. So in the framework part, we will cover all these things in very small parts. Okay, so that you can clearly understand each and every step by step. Okay, so let's meet at the framework class. Okay guys, so see you in the next session. Bye bye.